Let us understand the historical background, the paths and the functioning, the uses, and the reason for redundancy of a cathode ray tube.
The idea of television electronic transmission of moving pictures goes back to the earliest form of electronic communication, the telegraph, which began connecting the world in 1837. As telegraph wires started crossing nations, people almost immediately started working on advancements, like the ability to transmit spoken voices rather than just dots and dashes, the ability to transmit without wires, and surprisingly early, the ability to transmit pictures. In 1860, an Italian priest, Giovanni Caselli, invented the pen telegraph. The device would transmit across normal telegraph lines. Devices at both ends would be synchronized with a pendulum. The message would be written with insulating ink on a metal plate. The synchronized receiving apparatus would use a piece of paper and impregnate it with a chemical that darkened when the current passed through it. This process was early version of what is called rasterization, stacking lines to make an image called a raster image, which would be a critical part to develop the television. Cathode rays were discovered by Julius Plucker and Johann Wilhelm Hettorf. In 1890, Arthur Schuster demonstrated cathode rays could be deflected by electrical field, and William Crookes showed that they could be deflected by magnetic field. Worldwide, the sales of CRT TVs peaked in 2005 at 130 million units. Beginning in the late 90s to the early 2000s, CRTs began to be replaced by LCDs. This was noted as the beginning of the demise of CRT television.
A cathode ray tube is made up of electron gun assembly, the phosphor viewing surface, and the glass envelope. The first important part of the cathode ray tube is the heated metal cathode, also known as the electron gun. The heat is applied to the cathode, which gets the electrons heated up. These electrons then start ejecting as a stream of negatively charged electrons, which later accelerates towards the phosphor screen. The second important part of CRT is the phosphorus screen. The function of the fluorescent screen is to convert the electrical signals into visual patterns. The third important part of the CRT is the deflecting system. The function of the deflector system is to deflect the electron beam horizontally or vertically. Therefore, it is also known as electron beam deflector.
Uses of cathode ray. Cathode ray was widely used in TVs and computer monitors. In these color devices, an image is produced by controlling the intensity of each of three electron beams, one for each primary color, red, green, and blue, with a video signal as a reference. The primary advantage that CRT monitors hold over LCDs is color rendering. The contrast ratios and depths of color displayed on the CRT monitors are better than what an LCD can render. Hence, we see that it is still used today in radar screens, oscilloscopes that are used in scientific works, and imaging equipment that is used in space exploration.
There were several factors which caused the CRT to become obsolete. Most common answers mentioned as a cause for redundancy of CRT is the fact that cheaper, cost-efficient, safer, and better quality display systems have emerged in the market since the dawn of 2000s. For those who had CRT television sets at home, we would recall our elders reminding us to sit at a distance from the screen. This is because CRTs emit radiation, which could get intensified if they malfunctioned. Older models of CRTs emitted X-rays from them. For the acceleration of electrons occurring in the CRT, which resulted in making the displayed images brighter, they needed a higher voltage supply to do so, roughly 27,000 volts. Harmful ionized particles, chances of getting electrified, and fire were other reasons why CRT were not safe to be close to. Chances were that the vacuum chamber in the CRT could implode due to the decaying quality. A minor crack in the neck of the CRT or in any part of the system, so to speak, could cause an implosion in this device. The CRT glass contained 14 to 23% of lead by weight, which needed to absorb the excess radiation and keep it safe. But in terms of disposal, lead disposal would be harmful due to the poisonous effects on the environment and causing damage to the nervous system and other effects like headache, cognitive defects, etc. Considering these effects, people began to choose smarter, safer, and cost-effective devices as part of their daily usage.